I have decided. I will choose a handsome. come and look in the garden. Such excitement with music and singing. You'll enjoy it enormously. Don't miss it. It will simply delight you.
I can hardly wait to see.
Come, I invite you.
Shaking, and I'm suffering from stage fright.
It seems I have forgotten all my lines.
Dear ladies, please encourage them.
Say something. Don't be afraid to say what's on your mind.
Dear lady,
no, dearest ladies,
you make the speech.
No, no, you're so much better.
Why? This is too ridiculous. The way you are behaving is hopelessly old-fashioned. Despinetta, if they can't talk themselves, I'll do it for them. You do it for the lady.
Step forward a little and do as I do. If you are too timid, I will speak for you. I will speak for you. I will speak for you. If we have displeased you, we truly lament it. If we have disturbed you, we deeply repent it. To slaves who adore you,
adore you,
come to implore you,
implore you.
Whatever you ask us, we gladly will do. Whatever you ask us, we gladly will do.
We gladly will do.
We gladly will do.
We gladly will do.
We gladly will do. And now, you must answer, my ladies, you must answer. You're silent. You are laughing.
Since they are so bashful, so modest and shy, I'll venture to give you my lady's reply. I'll venture to give you my lady's reply. Let us forget what happened and think about the future.
I think it a trifle too warm.
Oh, how lovely the trees are.
Absolutely. However, rather far more leaves than fruit.
Takes your fancy.
Most obliging.
Now we're at the crossroads.
What was that you told him?
I was merely suggesting there is moss on the road. I think it a trifle too warm.
Oh, how lovely the trees are.
Absolutely. However, rather far more leaves than fruit.
Whatever takes your fancy.
Most obliging.
Now Now we are at the crossroads.
What was that you told him?
I was merely suggesting there is moss on the road.
Shall we also take a walk?
With greatest pleasure. Good Lord.
Is something wrong?
All at once I feel dreadful. Perhaps it's some kind of fever. I may even be dying.
I don't believe a word of it. You're still feeling the effects from the poison you've taken.
There is a far more deadly poison, a far more fatal danger in the flames of your cool, glorious eyes.
A flattering comparison. You ought to write a poem.
You really should not tease me when you know how I'm suffering. I can't see them. What on earth have they gone to?
Don't be so silly.
You are heartless and cruel to go on yoking.
I'm yoking. I'm yoking.
Won't you show me some sign of pity? Fairest of ladies, to uphold my morale.
Only too gladly. Merely say what you wish, and you shall have it.
She's fooling, or could she be serious? Won't you do me one favor? Let me give you this locket.
A heart!
A heart! A most appropriate symbol to reassure you of my everlasting love.
A wonderful present!
You accept it.
I'd like to! My heart is not free, as you well know.
The iceberg is melting. I'm sorry, but my soldierly word can't be broken. I love you.
Please don't.
I love you madly.
Don't say that.
Do not reject me.
I insist that you go.
If you reject me, I'm determined to perish. Who will take it?
I'll take it.
What a blow for Ferrando. Never forsake it.
explosion. Scorpion, hydra, and vicious serpent, and all the horrifying monsters you could imagine, you have seen them in me.
I mean it.
certain we've done it?
Yes, it's a famous victory. Your dirige is fidelity incarnate.
Bravo you, bravo me, bravo my true Penelope.
And my dear Dorabella, how did you fare with her? Why do I even ask you? I know your answer. How could I ever doubt it?
A little doubting, my dear undoubting friend, might be advisable at times.
What's that? Are you implying she yielded to your advances? I won't believe it. I will never suspect her.
You would be wiser to leave a little room for some suspicion.
What do you mean? Speak up. If you must poison me, get it over and done with. But no, it can't be. Tell me that you are joking. I am her love, and she loves only me.
Surely. And to prove the fact beyond any question, she gave me this delightful little portrait.
Gave you my portrait? Oh, shame on her!
Where are you going?
To tear the heart out of her faithless bosom and to avenge. Devotion slighted.
Arm yourself.
No, I will not.
This is madness. Why do you want to ruin yourself on a woman who is so completely worthless? I must try to prevent him from doing something foolish.
Heavens, all her devotion, her promises, her affection, her protestation, all have vanished entirely.
That seems to be the case.
My life is ruined. What shall I do now? What aim in life is left me? Pity a broken heart. Help me, I beg you.
My friend, I am afraid there's no advice I can give.
Treacherous and heartless, in a day, in a moment.
It is certainly a case to make you wonder. Something on my mind, it's a basic human problem, and it touches all mankind. Yes, it touches all mankind. Like my fellow men and brothers, I have worshipped before your shrine. Like 100 million others, like 100 million others, I believe you were divine. I've respected and protected your good name in every way. Yes, in each and every way. Thankless, lovely, lovely, lovely ladies, fill my soul with deep dismay. Fill my soul with deep dismay. With my sword I saved your virtue. I have fought a fearless fight. I've discovered and uncovered every plot designed to hurt you. I have been your peerless knight. You thankless, lovely, lovely, lovely ladies, put my chivalry to flight. Put my chivalry to flight. You are delightful, you are adorable. You are pleasant, you are sweet. You are gracious, fair, and lovable. And we men are at your feet. And we men are at your feet. But, you wicked, lovely, lovely, lovely ladies, shock my heart with your deceit. Shock my heart with your deceit. In the most poetic phrases, I have sung your senseless praises. I have lauded and applauded and extolled you to the sky. To the sky,
But you thankless lovely ladies, you lovely, lovely ladies, you wicked lovely, lovely, lovely ladies. When I see how you mistreat us, I begin to wonder why, to wonder why. When I see how you mistreat us and how callously you cheat us, I begin to wonder why, to wonder why. To wonder why, I begin to wonder why. To wonder why, I begin to wonder why. To wonder why, to wonder why, I begin to wonder why.
Distracted and torn apart by conflicting thoughts and emotions. I'm so stunned by misfortune, so disillusioned, that there's no one able to give me counsel. Alfonso, Alfonso, how you laugh me to scorn, mock at my self-delusion. But I shall be avenged. I'll tear her image from my heart and my memory, and shall not regret her. No, dear God, since my heart will not forget her. Rejected, neglected, my heart grieved and sore, my heart grieved.
Should be.
Stay away from me. You have caused all my misery.
Learn how to take it calmly, and you'll be so much the wiser. The fact is, Fiordiligi was faithful. At least up to now. But Doramella, she was too weak to resist.
Yes, to my shame.
Dear Ferrando, you must be able to put the matter in perspective.
Where would you find a woman who'd refuse a Guglielmo? If you compare us, I say it in all modesty, you will have to admit, if you are honest, I have a slight advantage.
He's got a point there.
And now suppose you pay me my half of the wager.
I'll be glad to. But before I pay up, permit me to try one more experiment.
What's that?
You both must be patient. Until tomorrow, you are bound to our wager. And just remember, you gave your word of honor to obey my command. All right. I hope I have made it clear that I am still competing, for the proof of the pudding is in the
convinced. lady call. Now take this key, and without questions and without contradictions, go to the wardrobe, find and bring me two swords, two helmets, and both the uniforms you'll find there.
What for, if I may ask?
Go now, ask no questions.
What a fine way to talk. Behind my teeth.
My uniform of Guglielmo should be just about my size, and Dorabella can dress up in Ferrando's. Disguised as soldiers, we shall go and join our lovers. In the midst of the battle, no one will know.
happening to me? To a Guglielmo, victimized by a woman.
Compose yourself, I beg you.
The devil with composure. I could tear my hair out. I'm so furious, I don't know what I'm doing. Was that my fiore di Ligi?
My Penelope.
The paragon of virtue. That vixen, that assassin, that serpent, tigress, viper.
Let him get it off his chest.
When?
Where is she?
Who, your good fiore di Ligi?
My good fiore di Diablo. The devil may take her and me with her.
Do you remember, I say without the least bit of conceit, I have a slight advantage.
Oh, stop it! Stop being so sarcastic! We must think of some way to punish those two women most severely.
I'll tell you how. You marry them.
I'd rather go to hell and sell my soul to the devil.
And battle with the Furies.
Consumed in fire and brimstone.
Then you will end your days as lonely bachelors.
There are plenty of women who are worthy of men like us.
I don't deny that. However, you think they would be different? You might as well admit it. You love your unfaithful little sweetheart. Yes, we love them.
Oh, it's the pity.
Why don't you marry them just as they are? What gives you the right to demand of nature to make exceptions and create two superhuman women just because you would like it? Whatever happens, we must be philosophical. There's only one way to make your future happy, and I will make the arrangements. Before this evening, you shall both wear a wedding ring. But meanwhile, let me act as your advisor. If you take it to heart, you'll be the wiser. Women cannot be faithful, but I don't mind it. I can see the principle behind it. You are all to braid them. You have to take them as they are, as Mother Nature made them. You lovers, there is only one conclusion. They are always untrue. It's no illusion. Be they youthful, aged, or ugly, or a beauty. Say the word after me, cosy fan to.
On the play within the play. everything that's needed, and the cobbles over here.
We are living on the country.
Here's the lawyer, Beck Kavivi. Kindly come in.
This man is someone hiding. It's a lawyer. Why is he here?
For tomorrow's masquerade.
There is no one like this man.
Oh,
It's a contract. Yes, a contract. It's a dance.